What I want to stress is that like a painter goes through many iterations of his or her final masterpiece, going back to resketch, redraw, change canvases, layer paint, etc., the data visualization process is not simply just the frosting on a data analysis cake after it's been baked, but a fundamental and integral part of the process as a whole. And while you may read this graphic from left to right, each stage is often iterative, and you'll find yourself traversing this process in a somewhat nonlinear fashion. One step may better inform what you have done in a previous step. For example, maybe only once you visualize your data that you realize that there are way too many points to make sense of, and you need to go back and filter and mine your data to transform it into a new form that might be much more easy to understand from a visual perspective. Also, you can imagine some insight that you might discover in an earlier stage that you might want to incorporate in your final visualization, or some new data that you find online that you think will add more context and bolster the narrative you've created. And while data visualization in and of itself is a very expansive discipline ranging from interactive art installations that data artists produce to business analytical dashboards and charts, one of the running themes throughout this course will be how to best leverage the principles that we learn about visualization theory combined with technologies like D3 to communicate our data and insights in the most effective manner.